能听见我的声音吗？
你把你的音声打开一点。
现在可以听到我的声音吗？
你的麦克风，我这是mute。
喂，
现在，
老师，你听得到吗？
现在我能听到你们的声音。
他听得到我们。
能听到我的声音吗？
可以。
那谁要？那下面这个帅哥。
他说 ，online speaker 可以听得到。其他吴梦如说 ，online speaker 可以听得到。
我们
听不到。
这是我们的喇叭。
对对，
可能
我们
去
吃
个，
所以搞不来这样问题。
我用一个电脑，然后拿喇叭对着它，放到我听。
对啊，我们说他可以听得到。
那我你们的电脑呢？
我那是不是 OK？ 所以不是他问题，是我们问题，是我们问题。信箱的。
那个呢？你用那个电脑听，就能听到。
我们是可以听得到。
你听得到他讲话吗？
可是你听得到我们吗？
现在能听到我的声音吗？
可以了，耶！ OK, that's great. So we can hear you now, 刘翔。
好。OK,
我们听你听得很清楚 ，OK。
哦，那好，可以，那我就报告了哈。Firstly, Firstly, I would like to thank the organizer to invite me to give this talk. So in this talk, I will introduce some progress for the army-like state, white states. So I want to show some sort of solution.For the why problem. So in this talk, I will firstly introduce some background for the why problems. And then I will introduce the fiber-like interference. So by introducing this interference, so I will show some results for the Y4230 and other why state. So in the following, I will also introduce the Nat'l structure along the 2.2 GeV.4.2 GeV. So this state is very important to construct the GFSI family with. So I will introduce our progress in this study. So firstly, I will focus on the why problems. So we know that in the 1915, so many light hadrons were absorbed by the experiment. So Guillemin and Zuig proposed the Park model and found the SU3. So and to categorize these light hadrons into different representation. So they also predict the omega state, and then the experiment find this omega state. I think this is very important to construct the quark model. So we also face the same situation. So in this slide, I will introduce some the status of Chamonix family. So we know that in 1974, many Chamonix states listed in the partial data group were absorbed by the experiment. So in this site, I list this Chamonix-like state. So for describing the mass spectrum of this Chamonix-like state, the Kanea group introduced the Kanea model. In this model, they proposed a potential, like the Kanea potential, to describe the Chamonix family. This potential is composed by two terms. One is the linear potential. Another one is the Coulomb potential. So we know that according to this this potential, so there are many theoretic studies for the Nat'l for studying the Nat'l family and the Baron family. So different quark model were developed by the different groups. So since 2003, we also faced a new situation for the Chamonix-like state. So in this slide, I also show some observations for the XYZ state. So according to the production mechanism, so we can find that there exist five groups. The first one is from the BD case, the weak decay. So there are many many states. The famous one is X3872. The second group is the is come from E plus E minus ignition into the Chamonix-like state. So in this talk, I will focus on this Chamonix-like state. So we also have other groups like the E plus E minus ignition. So you can notice that the final state there exists a gypsy particle and a plus a Chamonix-like state. So the Chamonix-like state can also be produced by the gamma-gamma fusion process. So in here, I list the three states here. So we also, I also want to emphasize another group. So like the charged Chamonix-like state. So these states come from the hadronic decays from the Y42-16. So if you have an interest, so you can find some review for this field. So I want to emphasize that so this situation is useful for us to identify the exotic state. So I think it's a very important issue in the hadron physics. So we know that the hadron include the conventional the state like the meson and the baryon. So there also exists the exotic state like the molecule state, hybrid meson, global tetrapark state, and the pentapark state. So I think it's very important to identify the exotic state by combining with these observations. I also want to emphasize another point. The observed XYZ state can provide us good platform to identify the exotic state, and also can provide a chance to construct the GSI family. So in this talk, I will focus on these issues. So here, I also show the experimental status from the E plus E minus accumulation. So you can notice that there are many Y states. So the first one is the Y4260. This state was observed in 2005 from the Baba experiment. They analyzed the E plus E minus to GPSI pi plus pi minus and found a peak. So later, many experiments announced the observation for the other Y states. So in this slide, I list the observations for this Y state. I also want to indicate that the Y problem was proposed by the best three corporation. In this corporation, so they wrote a white paper on the future physics program. So they indicate that there exists the Y problem. The Y problem is that how to understand this Y state, how to understand this lower phenomena. So in this talk, I will introduce our progress on these issues. So firstly, I will introduce the Fado-like interference. So I will introduce this interference effect to interpret the Y state. So firstly, I will briefly introduce the experimental status for the Y4260. So the Baba analysis the GPSI pi plus pi minus environment mass spectra and find a enhancement peak here. So you can notice that there exists a puzzle. The puzzle is that no evidence of the Y4260 in the R-scan value state and the open chain decay channels. So we also notice that there exists many theoretical explanation to the Y4260. So we can category these explanations into two groups. The first one is the exotic state explanation. So like the theorist introduced the Chamonix hybrid and the dichroic and dichroic state and the molecular state to explain the Y4260. So there also exists the conventional Chamonix assignment to the Y4260. But I want to emphasize that if you want to introduce the resonance explanation to the Y4260, you have to face the difficulty. The difficulty is that you, according to the calculation from the exotic state model and the conventional Chamonix assignment, so they predict that this state should be exist in the Ohm-Chan decay channel. So you can see that there does not exist any signal for the Y state. It's a problem for the resonance explanation to the Y4260. So for solving such difficult, so we once introduced a non-resonance picture for the Y4260. So we can notice the better experimental data. So you can notice that this state, this enhancement is not a symmetry. It means that you cannot simplify use a Brit Wigner to describe the this light shape. So we also notice that in the E plus E minus to pi plus pi minus GPSI closed session, so you cannot find the single find the enhancement for the Psi 41 16 and Psi 44 15. So we know that these two trombone-like states is were established in the PDG. So when we faced this situation, so we proposed that maybe this Y4260 can be reproduced by the interference between the Psi 4160 and Psi 4450. So we did a calculation in three papers. So we found that we can reproduce the experimental data well. It means that we can explain why two trombone-like states like Psi 4160 and Psi 4415 singular are missing in the data. So we can also naturally understand why no evidence of the Y4260 in the R value scan and the open trend decay channels. So I think the difficult can be solved by introducing the non-resonance picture of the Y4260. It means that the Y4260 is not a resonance in our models. So we in the following, I also want to introduce the experimental data for the Y4316. The situation is very is similar to the Y4260. It means that so you can find that this enhancement exists in the Psi 2s pi plus pi minus from the E plus E minus inclination. So the experimentalist also did not find the enhancement structure in the R value scan and in the open trend decay channels. So it's the same problem as the Y4260. So following the same idea, so we also introduced the follow-like interference effect to explain Y4360. So in this paper, I show the result for our from our model. So you can find that finally we can reproduce the experimental data for the Y4360. So it means that we can use the same mechanism to explain Y4260 and Y4360. So in 2017, the best three give a more precise date of the E plus E minus to G psi pi plus pi minus. In these papers, they found that the singular of Y4260 contains two substructure. The first one is the Y4220 and the second one is the 4330. So this is the new data. So for explaining this new data, so we restarted this process by introducing a nanostructure Y4220 and considering the fiber-like interference picture. So you can notice that. So if we did not introduce the nanostructure like the Y4220, so you can see that we cannot describe the experiment data around 4.2 GeV. It means that we have to introduce a nanostructure Y4220 to describe the details data around the 4.2 GeV. So you can see that when we introduce the new structure here, so we found that we can describe the data. And we can also find that the Y4330 can be killed. It means that the follow-like interference picture plays a resonant killer to the Y4330. So in this slide, I also want to emphasize a point. The resonance parameter from our study is that it's a nano structure. So you can find the resonance parameters. The width is nano. So you must be asked a question, what is the Y4220? So in the following, I will give an answer for this question. So in the another papers from the batch 3 experiment, so they studied the E plus E minus to H sub C pi plus pi minus. They also found the two resonance structure. The first one is Y4220, and another one is Y4319. So it means that more structure are reported were reported in the experiment. So we face the same situation, how to expand this Y state. So in this in our EPGS papers, so we also introduced the interference effect. I want to emphasize that the interference effect is very important to play the resonant killer for the newly absorbed Chomley-like state Y4313 and Y4319. It means that when we faced the new date from the batch 3, so we only need the Y4220. So it means that we only need to introduce another Y state here. So in this slide, I want to emphasize, give a summary for the situation for the situation of the Y state. So so we know that in the experiment, so there are many Y state reported by the batch 3 and the better experiment. So if we introduced the interference effect, so we found that the Y4360 and the Y4390 can be killed in our model. It means that so we only have three states here. In this slide, I marked the Y4220 as the with the red color. It means that I will focus on this this state and introduce our progress for expanding this Y state. So I want to emphasize that this Y state around the 4.2 GeV is a nano structure. It's very important. So firstly, I also want to introduce some old work from the Cornell group. So in the 1918, so the Cornell group did a calculation for the Chomley mass spectra. So you can notice that they predict that the 4S state is with the mass 4.4 GeV, which is consistent with the Psi 4415. It means that in this old paper, they propose that Psi 4415 is a good candidate for the 4S state in the Chomley family. So if you check the other theoretic calculation for after this work, so I think many theoretical group adopt this conclusion. So in my talk, I want to emphasize maybe this conclusion is not correct. So later I will introduce our progress for this point. So I also want to introduce another paper from Zhao group. So in 1995, they did a calculation by considering the screen potential and found that the 4S state is about 4.2 GeV. This conclusion is different from that of Cornell model. So this is I want to emphasize this point. So in the 2014, So we also studied this problem. So if you check the Chamoli family, and the Wuxian family, so we can find the similarity between the GFSI and the Wuxian family. So you can notice that the mass gap is similar. So it means that the Psi 4S, the gap between Psi 2S and the GSI is similar to the Wuxian 4S, 2S and the Wuxian 1S. So you can use the you can find the similar way for the higher state. So if we if you notice that there also exists a mass gap along the 200 MeV corresponding to the mass gap between the Wuxian 4S and the Wuxian 3S. So we can use this mass gap to make a prediction for the Psi 4S. We found that the Psi 4S mass should be located at 4.2 MeV. This result is consistent with the screen potential prediction of the Psi 4S. I want to emphasize that this one is very important. So maybe this one can provide a solution to explain the Y4220. So I also want to indicate another point is that this Psi 4S is a nanostate. According to our calculation, we found that due to the node effect, the width of the the width of the Psi 4S is a nano. So it means that so we can conjugate that the Psi 4S is just correspond to Y4220. So this I think this assumption should be tested in the experiment. So in the following, I also want to introduce some experimental evidence for the nanostructure exists in the 4.2 GeV from the batch 3. So you can notice that in the 2014, the batch 3 began to focus on this issue. So they measured the E plus E minus to GFSI pi plus pi minus process and the E plus E minus to the H sub C pi plus pi minus process and found that there exists the evidence for the nanostructure along the 4.2 GeV. So this is the experimental evidence. So later, the batch 3 also measured the E plus E minus to chi c zero omega process and found that there exists a peak exists in the 4.2 GeV with a nano width. So they also claim that the E plus E minus to chi c one omega and the E plus E minus to chi c two omega, the analysis that in these two process, they cannot find the peak. So if you take the mass of Psi 2S to be 13 MeV. So you can find that this process like the Psi 4S to chi c zero omega is allowed. Another process like the Psi 4S to chi c one omega and the Psi 4S to chi c two omega are forbidden this kinematically. So it's, this one is can explain why only E plus E minus to chi c zero omega was reported by the batch 3. So focusing on this batch 3 data, so we also did a calculation to to his hidden charm decay channels. So we introduced the Chamoli assignment to the Y4220. So you can notice that if we introduce the Psi 4S corresponding to this nano structure around the 4.2 GeV, so we can reproduce the the branch ratio for this process. It means that I want to emphasize that the cup channel effect plays a very important role to reproduce the branch ratio for this process. So you can notice that here we introduced the hadronic loop composed by composed of d-metron loop. It's d-metrons. So we can use this hadronic loop effect to describe the data. I think in this conclusion is that this Nat'l structure exists in the 4.2 GeV can be expanded as the 4.4S. This is our conclusion. So in another paper from our group, we also studied the E plus E minus to Psi 2S pi plus pi minus process. So in this paper, we want to emphasize that missing Psi 4S around 4.2 GeV exists in the Psi 2S pi plus pi minus environment mass spectra. So you can notice that there exists a small peak in the cross section data for the E plus E minus to the pi plus pi minus Psi 2S. So we also give the resonant parameters by fitting the data. So you can find that this one is a Nat'l structure here. So we also propose that the experiment list should be pay more attention to this structure. So we also studied the hidden chain, open chain, hidden chain decay channel for the Psi 4S. So we studied the Psi 4S to Psi 2S pi plus pi minus and make a comparison with the experiment data. So you can notice that we can also reproduce the branch ratio from the experiment measurement. So it means that this one, this state introduced by our group, located in the at the 4.2 GeV, this state can correspond to the 4.4 Psi 4S state. So I want to emphasize this point here. So we also give a combined fit to three process, like the E plus E minus to Psi 2S pi plus pi minus, and the H sub C pi plus pi minus, and the Chi C zero omega mentioned above. So we can find that we can get another fitting data for the resonance parameters for this Nat'l structure. So I show these parameters here. Yeah. So in 2017, so the best three measured the E plus E minus to pi plus pi minus Psi 2S process. So you can notice that in their conclusion. So they confirm of our prediction for this Nat'l structure exists in the Psi 2S pi plus pi minus environment mass spectra. So you can notice the data around the 4.2 GeV. There exists a small peak here. Okay, so if we want to expand the Y4220 as a Psi 4S state, it's a Chomonic-like Chomonic state. So we have to face the problem. So we know that for the higher Chomonic, the dominant decay is the open chain decay channel. It means that this state should be found in the open chain decay channel process. So fortunately, we found an interesting paper from the batch three in 2019. So in this paper, they analysis the E plus E minus to pi plus D zero and D star minus process. So you can notice that there exists a peak around 4.2 GeV. It means that if this one can be conformed by experiment. So it means that it provides a good evidence for supporting the traumatic assignment to the Y4220. So I think it's a very important progress for studying this nanostructure around 4.2 GeV. So I also want to talk about some lessons from the Pentapox studies. So we know that in 2005, the Pentapox CT Plus were reported by the experiment list. So later, according to the high precision data, the GLF experiment says that they did not find this peak in the NK environment mass spectrum. So so we know that the Pentapox event shows that we are still far from understanding the nature of QCD. So fortunately, after 10 years, so the LHCb experiment found the two Pentapox candidate, two PC state. I think there are many theoretical studies for this issue. So I also want to indicate that the status of Chamonix family shows our poor understanding of the QCD non-perturbative behavior. So I want to indicate another point is that the Y4220 is a key point to construct the GFSI family. So we know that there exist many Chamonix states. So in this site, I show some many Chamonix states reported by the experiment. But till now, we still cannot, we still did not establish the GFSI family. It's established for the Chamonix above the 4.4 GeV. It means that, so you can notice that there exists a threshold, DD bar threshold. So we can find that if you face the Chamonix state above the DD bar threshold, you can find many novel phenomena. So like the Psi 4S state. So we still did not establish this state. So we have other problems for the high state. So I want to say that the Y state around 4.2 GeV with the nano structure is a key point to construct the GFSI family, especially for the Chamonix state above the 4.2 GeV. So in the following, I will introduce the our progress for constructing the GFSI family with update data of the Chamonix-like Y state. So in last year, so we published a long paper. This paper, so we want to establish the GFSI family with the Y state. So I think it's important for our understanding for the GFSI family. So in this site, I want to show the situation, present situation of the Chamonix family. So you can find that there exists the state below the DD bar threshold. There also exist the many states above the DD bar threshold. So I want to in the following, I want to talk about our opinion for the description for the mass spectrum. So we found that the unquenched potential model is should be introduced in constructing the Jupiter family. So we can introduce the Hamiltonian like this way. So I emphasize that the linear confining potential, including in the potential, should be modified as these things. So it means that we should be including include the screen potential to describe the GSI family. So we did this calculation. So we found that we can reproduce the mass of this absorbed Chomoni state in the GSI family, like this state. So I also want to emphasize that why 4.2 why state around 4.2 GeV is a important scaling point to constructing the GeV family, especially for the Chomoni about the 4.4 GeV. So you can notice that in our calculation, so we can get the mass for the Psi 4S like this one. So the mass is about 4.2 GeV. So you can find that this theoretical mass is consistent with the experimental data. So we can also use the this way, we can describe the other observed the Chomoni. So we can also use this way to predict the some missing Chomoni. So we predict many missing Chomoni in this table. So in our work, we also introduced the mixing scheme from the 4S and the 3D. Why we need to introduce this mixing scheme? So you can notice that the calculate if we introduce the unquenched quark model, so we can give the predicted mass. So if you notice that if we take the mixing angle to be zero, it means that there are no mixing. So the Psi 4S is above the mass of the Y4220. So if we introduce the mixing to 30 degree, so you can find that we can get the same mass as the Y4220. So it means that we can we need to introduce the mixing scheme to further study the Y4220. I also want to emphasize that. So this one, we also get the total width for the Y4220. So you can notice that this state is also a narrow state. The dominant decay is the DD star. It means that the vect D metal pair is a dominant decay channel for the Y4220. So we can also find that there also exists the DD bar channel to pseudo scalar state. So I think this omicron decay channel is very important for identify the Y4220 state. So I also want to
3 minutes.
Okay, how? So I also want to predict the Psi 43 19, which is the pattern of Y4220. So I show some the decay width for this state. It means that the total width of Psi 43 19 has a significant enhancement. So I also noticed that in the DD2 decay channels, there also exists some hint for the Psi 43 90. So I think the future experiments should test this prediction. So in this slide, I also want to emphasize that the experimental evidence for the prediction of the Psi 43, 90. So you can notice that if we introduce the psi 43, 90, so we can reproduce the data where this data is come from the e plus e minus to pi plus pi minus psi 2s. So I also introduced the 5s to 4D mixing scheme to explain the psi 44, 15. And we also can get the consistent results with the experimental data. So we can also predict another pattern for the psi 44, 15. It means another psi state along the 4.5 GeV. So in this site, I also want to indicate that we still need more precise data of the resonance parameter of the psi 44, 15. So we know that if you collected the data from the experiment, so you can find that the resonance parameter for the psi 44, 15 is not good. So it means that we need more data. So if we have more data, so we can test this mixing scheme for the psi 44, 15. So I think I can finish my talk. So I will give a summary for my talk. So the white state from the E plus E minus inclination, I think is very important to construct the high Chomolyg family. So I think it's a research field for of the opportunity and the challenge. So we also need more theoretical and experimental effort to this this issue. Okay, thank you. Thank you very much.
Thank you. Question from the audience?
So shall I stop? I have one feeling when you guys doing all this exotic states. Okay, whenever you find some states, you always find some two particles, the mass is close, and then in doing fitting, and then you always find a way to say, okay, I can produce this. So is there a more systematic way of doing such an analysis?
Yeah. Yeah. So when we face many white states, so for theorists, so we have a puzzle for this situation. It means that if we have a more white state here from the experiment, so we have to introduce the, like you can introduce the exotic state explanation to this white state, but unfortunately, so we cannot understand such more state. It means that we have to face the difficult to explain the white state only by introducing the exotic state here. So so in our studies, I want to emphasize that maybe this Y state can be if we introduce the interference effect, so we cannot we only need to three state here. So it's I think in this one it's it's simple for us. So it means that we can find that the Y4220 this state can be assigned to the GPSI family. It means that we cannot we did not introduce the exotic here. Yeah.
Further comments?
No. I'm fine.
Any other question from audience? If not, let's thank Professor Liu again. Our second talk will be from our side speaker, Xiang Nan from the famous cinema. His title is QCD Sun Rules
is an inverse problem.
Okay.